Hi, my name is Ezekiel. Hope you are doing well today. In this video, I'm going to talk to you on how I mix a rap vocal in the entire Cakewalk by Bandlab. The artist's name is Bright Legend. He's a young and upcoming artist trying to get himself together, and he's doing this for a presentation. While I was calling one of the new studio that I work with recently, I just grabbed my laptop. Getting there, and while the artist was preparing himself with the lyrics, I was also preparing myself and selecting my mixing tools in Cakewalk by Bandlab. There's nothing more than Cakewalk by Bandlab on it. By doing this, I love using the Cakewalk and console emulator, tube emulator, tape emulator, one knob saturation by soft tube in Cakewalk by Bandlab, multiband compressor, channel strip EQ. On this song, I want a kind of old rap mix in balance with this modern day mix. That's why I'm using this kind of plugins that are being part of my favorite plugins to create a balance in the transient and energy into the mix, into the entire song. So I'll play the song for you. You'll listen to the song with no plugin, and then I'll explain what I do. Try and get his love from time to sleep for a nigga like me. I just need my kiss to go to school. Play my life, no be something so joke. He said I wasn't ready. Nigga hold me money, said I was putting on that fucking fake Fendi. Maybe it was a Nike. He thought I couldn't get it. Was more better though. This tough shit made me chase my dream. My heart, even when I see that hood, man, on my fucking teeth. The nigga can go to school, my country. There's enough for the youth. Nigga down my street. Just for some fucking chain, nigga. Use me, my nigga, I'm sure. That's the song that you just listened to. But before we move on, if you're new to this channel, I want you to subscribe and click the notification button. So you'll be the first person to be aware whenever I upload any video like this. And if you really like the content I'm creating and you want to be a support to this channel, please check the link below by doing this, so you'll be part of the Patreon to this channel. So by supporting this channel, I'll be able to create more content for people to learn from. I really appreciate you in advance. Thank you so much. So now I want to go into the real business. I'll show you, firstly from the beat, I'll introduce to you what I do on it to calm the beats down, to create a kind of balance in the transient and to make it sound in line with the rap vocal that I want to do on it. So let's just go into that. First thing I'm going to show you on the instrumental is the channel strip EQ. So I'll play the instrumental, I'll turn off the EQ, and I'll turn it on. You can hear the difference in how it sounds like. First thing I did, I applied the high pass filter to clean up the rumbleness in the lower end. Then I'm cutting down 240 Hz up to minus 3 dB to create a moderacy in the frequency response of this instrumental. I want it to sound clean. That's the reason why I'm cutting down up to minus 3 dB on that section. Now the next thing I'm going to show you is tip emulator. So you hear the difference on when I turn it on or when I turn it off, and I'll explain to you what I did on it. Basically what I use it for is to add a kind of analog feel and to control the signal to make it balance a bit, and also trying to reshape the whole frequency spectrum of the audio for me. So that's what I'm using the tape emulator for. The next thing I'm going to show you is the Sonitus Multiband. Now let me play the music again. I'll turn it on.
Maybe it was a Nike. He thought I couldn't get it. Was motivated though. This tough shit
Make me chase my dream, my heart, even when I see that hold man on my.
So nothing much on what I did on this section. I'm just compressing up to minus 34.5 dB or threshold above 1.3K to control the rimshot of the snare. There's a kind of unpleasant frequency that I'm hearing there. I'm only using this multiband to control that frequency. So I'm quickly going to show you on the EQ settings.
Back from the motion, you could call me and yes, you could. I just need a little time, then I go see my mama and yes, I would. I've been in the studio all night. I try and get this love from time to sleep for a nigga like me. I just need my kiss girl to school. Play my life, nigga, tell me so joke. You said I wasn't ready.
So you can hear the difference now. So let me quickly explain to you what I did here. Almost 4K, I'm cutting down up to 3.8. I'm also cutting down about 700 Hz on the mid frequency. I want to create a kind of balanced frequency spectrum on the audio. Now is a PCA leveler. Let's just listen to that again and see what is happening here. What I'm doing here is I'm using the PC2A leveler to create and balance up the audio signal for me and to make the instrumental sit so tight, and also at the same time it's adding more to the energy and also creating a kind of nice, smooth, crispy frequency in the shape that is giving me. I'm applying the limit. I'm also from the high frequency resistor here, I'm just turning on to, I don't want it to do much of compression or to compress one frequency too much. That's why I'm just turning it off. I'm just rolling that one off so to have more energy for me. On the next thing, I'm just turning up the tube emulator just for my signal to pass through. On the console emulator, let me quickly play the song. I will dial in with the buttons and you will hear the difference and you will understand what it's doing for me here. What the console emulator is doing for me is, number one, it gives me a kind of analog console feel, and it colors my audio for me, and it makes my instrumental sound great more. It adds more energy into the transient of the audio for me. By using the A-type is more brighter, and the S-type, N-type, S-type is more of a vintage console, and N-type is more of like a NIV and SSL type, NIV type and API type. That's a kind of the emulation that is on this console emulator. They have the nice attributes. This is one of the reasons why it's my basic console emulation, every of my channel stripping, every of my mix. That's how I use it. So listen to that, how it sounds more. Let's hear the rap vocals sound like in this one.
For some fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. Just feel under the ground, still standing. We are black women, mama cries on that. And all the fun we done had. All this.
What I'm doing on the PCU type compressor is I'm driving the input gain up to 10 dB. Then my attack is 0.4 ms. My release is about 510 ms, then my output is in the 0 dB. My threshold on this one is 8.0 and my dry wet knob is about 67%. What I'm doing here is I still want the signal to be controlled, and at the same time I want the raw signal to still pass through. The next one is B Reverb 2 from Cakewalk by Bandlab. I'm using this one to create a kind of ambience into the rap vocal due to the nature of the instrumental, the stem that the guy got. I want to create the same ambience in the same environment, in the same room. That's why I'm creating a kind of ambience for the vocal. I'm using this type of reverb. I'm still retaining the dry, the wet. I've been breaking down a bit. Just listen to this one now.
For some fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. 6 feet under the ground, still standing. We are black women, mama.
You can hear the kind of smoothness, the wetness, and the rap vocal when I turn it on. By the time everything plays together, you will hear the rap vocal like it's they perform together in the same place. The next one I want to show you the Shannon Strip EQ. I'll turn on the EQ and I'll explain to you what I did.
For some fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. 6 feet under the ground, still standing. We are black women, mama cry.
Let me quickly explain to you. On the low frequency, I'm cutting down 220 hertz up to minus 5.4 dB. Then on the high mid, just with a narrow bell controlled, 552 hertz. That's what I'm cutting down up to minus 0.13 dB. Almost 2K, I'm cutting down about minus 4.7 dB. At the same time, I'm cutting above 6.1K on the high frequency. Very tiny, narrow bell. So I'm just cutting down above minus 5.2 dB. So this is exactly what I'm doing on the Channel Strip EQ. So, okay, let me show you what Sonitus Multiband does for me.
For some fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. 6 feet under the ground, still standing. We are black women. Mama cries on that. And all the fun we done had, all the shit we done did. Yeah, I just pray for that forgive.
Basically, what I'm doing here is, let me explain to you. So on the low mid side, above 300 hertz, which is 324 hertz, I'm compressing that much. My threshold is minus 28.4 dB. Then my attack is 15 ms. My release time is 200 ms. My ratio is 29 according to the parameter setting here. I really don't want to compress much, but I really want it to be controlled. On the high mid section, about 1.2K, having the threshold is minus 33 dB. My release time is 184 ms. My attack is 10.6 ms. And my ratio is 3.3. Listen to it once again and turn it off, turn it on, so you can hear the difference and you can understand what it's doing for me.
For some fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. 6 feet under the ground, still standing. We are black women.
You can feel the difference. You can hear it and you can understand it now. That give me a kind of smoothness also. It give me a kind of controlled rap vocal. And let's see what Cakewalk, HF Exciter and Cakewalk EQ. Let's see the attributes they make into the rap vocal for me.
For some fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure.
Okay.
That you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. 6 feet under the ground, still standing. We are black women.
Turn it off again.
On that. And all the fun we done had, all the shit we done did. Yeah, I just
prefer to forgive again. On the frequency section, like 6K, this is what I'm using. The drive, I'm turning the drive all the way to 50%, I'm leaving there. The spread, I'm not spreading the frequency. So, and I'm mixing with 50%. I don't want it to do much, but I still want the high frequency to be retained in there because it's a rap vocal. I want all those things in the attribute. I want the kind of rhythmic and percussive element in the rap vocal. That's what I'm, the reason why I'm using this one. Okay, the next one is the EQ. Listen to it, I will turn it on.
For some fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. 6 feet under the ground, still standing. We are black women, mama cry.
You can also hear the difference and the kind of naturality in the rap vocal for me when I turn it on. I don't do much. I'm trying to like deconstruct and reconstruct back, destroy and rebuild back. That's what I'm trying to do for this rap vocal. On the low frequency, I'm just turning the high pass filter, so about up to 51 hertz. Third one, about 1K, that's 968 hertz, about minus 3 dB, just cutting down. PC2A leveler, let me show you the soft top saturation, what it does for me.
For some fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. Just feel under the ground, still standing. We are black women.
My input gain, I'm driving it to up to 50%. My peak reduction is in default setting 50%. I'm scorching the signal in, still retaining the output gain, creating a kind of energy and the aggressiveness in that rap. So retaining the level, not to be going down or not to be coming out back again. So that's just what I'm doing about that. On the soft tube, listen to it again. So I'll also play it to you. You listen to what it does for me.
Fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. Just feel under the ground, still standing. We are black women. Mama cries on that. I know the fun we done had. All the shit we done did. Yeah, I just pray for that forgiveness. We ain't picking blenders and we ain't got time to...
When I turn on the soft tube, you can hear the attitude, the energy, the attributes, like a kind of an aggressive rapper. In this one, and when I turn off all the plugin buttons, you can hear the weakness in the rap vocal, that it's weak, it doesn't have the kind of attributes as an experienced and a huge rapper. But with this one, brings up everything and add more to energy and the attitude into my rapping, into my rap vocal. This is exactly the kind of the thing I want in this one. My tip, I'm going to turn it on. You listen to how it controls the signal also.
For some fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. Just feel under the ground, still standing. We are black women. Mama cries on.
What I'm trying to do is when I turn it on, it's like bringing everything into your face and still controlling the stereo wideness to make it expand. And by the time you listen to everything together, so you see that it's sitting down. Let me quickly show you something that I intentionally doing on the whole rap vocal.
For some fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was
I'm intentionally want to create a kind of distortion in the rap vocal. I wanted to have a kind of rigid, a strong rap vocaling in this song. So lastly, my console emulator, like I explained earlier on, I'm using the 8 type to have the notch on the high end to reshape. And so listen to it again if you're not really sure.
For some fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. Just feel under the ground, still standing. We are black women. Mama cries on that. And all the fun we done had. All the shit we done.
I want to show you another thing I apply. I apply Sonitus delay smoothly. So let me quickly show you how I'll turn it on. So I'm not doing much on that. So the factor is 1/2, 3/4. The button is I'm using host, so to follow the timing, the kind of the delay. So just listen to that in a short time.
For some fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my...
So listen with the music.
For some fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. Just feel under the ground, still standing. We are black women, mama cries on that. And all the fun we done had, all the shit we done did. Yeah, I just pray for that forgive. We ain't picking blenders and we ain't got time to race horses. He might be your homie, but he ain't your dog for real. I see what the mixing link with that lemonade. Niggas been at door, my nigga, season wasn't for great. All these bitches wanna fuck me now, cause I'm little.
So you can feel the attributes of the delay in the song. So I'm still making to beat in within the ambience. So now I want to show you the reverb.
For some fucking chain, nigga, if you use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. Just feel under the ground, still standing. We are black women, mama cries on that. I know the fun we done had, all the shit we done did. Yeah, I just pray for that forgive. We ain't picking blenders and we ain't got time to race horses. He might be your homie, but he ain't your dog for real. I see what the mixing link with that lemonade. Mickey's been at go, my nigga, season wasn't for great. All these bitches wanna fuck me now, cause I'm little as fuck. I got fucking her, nigga, yeah.
The parameter setting for the time is almost 500 ms. The delay time is 18.9 ms. The stereo is in the center, so I'm not expanding the stereo, I just leave it like that. The EQ gain is 2.0. The frequency that I gain up is 1.0K. So the high shelf, I'm giving it the total width. Nothing more than that. Basically, that's what I'm doing on that. So just listen to it one more time.
For some fucking chain, nigga, use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. Just feel under the ground, still standing. We are black women, mama cries on that. And all the fun we done had, all the shit we done did. Yeah, just before that for.
So, what I'm trying to do on that is I just want to create an ambience for the rap vocal. Okay, now I have these few things to show you on this last stage. Okay, on this master bus, just listen to the way it sounds like, and then I'll turn it on. Then you listen to everything that I'm gonna show you.
For some fucking chain, nigga, use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. Just feel under the ground, still standing. We are black women, mama cries on that. And all the fun we done had, all the shit we done did. Yeah, just pray for that, forgive, we ain't picking blood as I'm.
Firstly, I'm using the Chinese triple EQ to control the frequency on the 2K, a kind of nasal, which I really don't really like the way it's sounding on the overall mix. Afterward, I'm gonna go on the let me show you this.
For some fucking chain, nigga, use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. Just feel under the ground, sister.
So what I'm using that one today is to control the overall signal, the music, the everything that I've just shown you since, to make everything glued together and giving me a nice stereo output. I'm also using the vintage type. So take a look at this one. Here, my attack is 15.0 mm. My release time is 200 mm. Also, I'm applying, I'm turning on the limiter, basically, and give me a nice one. So the next one I'm going to show you is a boost. Also from Cakewalk.
For some fucking chain, nigga, use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. Just feel under the ground, still standing. We are black women, mama cries on that. I know the fun we done had.
So, with this one, it's bringing everything into my face. When you listen to it, everything does shoot out into your face. I gain more stereo wideness with a little attribute of each plugin. There's not too much compression in it, but everything just shoots out, everything comes up, and it makes good sense. Why you listen to us? With my usual console emulator. So let me just show you briefly what I did on that. This master bus.
For some fucking chain, nigga, use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. Just feel under the ground, still standing. We are black women, mama cries on that. And all the fun we done had, all the shit we done did. Yeah, just pray for that, forgive, we ain't picking bladders and we ain't got time to race horses. He might be your homie, but he ain't your dog for real. I see what the mixing link.
I don't know if you can feel what I'm feeling. You can feel the difference when I turn it off, when I turn it on, and when I try to crank the drive and try to raise it up more. It gives a kind of balance, a kind of more energy and the depth into my signal. This is one of the reasons why I love console emulator. I love saturation a lot. It does a lot of different works for you to enhance your work, to make your work sound so good. Thanks for watching. If you really enjoyed this video, if you love what I'm doing, what I'm creating, please stumble for me and share this video to some other people that might need to learn something on this one. Thanks for watching. See you next time.
For some fucking chain, nigga, use me, my nigga, I'm sure that you would feel the same. October 10, 2020 was a hanging for all my niggas. Just feel under the ground, still standing. We are black women, mama cries on that. And all the fun we done had, all the shit we done did. Yeah, just pray for that, forgive, we ain't picking bladders and we ain't got time to race horses. He might be your homie, but he ain't your dog for real. I see what the mixing link with that lemonade. Niggas been at door, my nigga, season wasn't fall great. All these bitches wanna fuck me now, cause I'm little as fuck.